In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to perform scenario management in GeoHECRAS. One of the powerful features of the Army Corps' HECRAS software is its ability to support multiple geometry files as well as multiple flow files. The software does this through its use of plans. What GeoHECRAS has done is made management of multiple plans much simpler for the user to perform. It makes it much easier for the user to switch between different plans. In this project, there is both an existing conditions plan and another plan containing a new bridge for a proposed roadway crossing. From the left side on Input Ribbon menu, we can switch to the plan which contains the proposed roadway crossing. If we look at the Scenario Manager dialog box, we can see that we can make copies of existing geometries and flows. In addition, we can create new plans, or what GeoHECRAS refers to as scenarios, by selecting the geometry and flow files to use. All this allows us to manage multiple plans more easily. Let's take a look at an example exercise utilizing this. For these two plans or scenarios, we are going to analyze both of them and then compare their results. To do that, switch to the Analysis ribbon menu. Then, from the Compute Steady menu item, select the drop-down menu and choose Multiple Scenarios. This will display a dialog box, allowing us to select which multiple plans to simultaneously analyze using HECRAS. From this dialog box, we will choose to analyze both the existing geometry and proposed roadway crossing plans. Analyze these plans, click the Compute button. The HECRAS computations will then run twice, once for each plan. After the computations have completed, click on the Close button to close the dialog box. Next, switch to the Results ribbon menu. From there, select Profile Plot menu command. This will display the Profile Plot results window for the current plan. Click on the Profiles drop-down entry and turn off the 25-year and 500-year flows so that we are only looking at the 100-year flow. Now, right-click on the Profile Plot and from the Displays context menu, select Landmarks and then River Stationing. This will display the cross-section locations on the profile plot. Next, we are going to turn off some of the profile plot output, allowing us to get a clearer view of the results. Again, right-click on the profile plot and from the displayed context menu, select Variables. This displays a dialog box that allows us to control which variables are to be displayed on the profile plot. In this dialog box, we are going to uncheck the filled-in water surface and energy grade elevation options. Keep in mind, though, you typically want the energy grade elevation option turned on when doing a bridge analysis. We are also going to uncheck the critical depth elevation option. Next, click OK to close the dialog box. And just like that, we can now see the 100-year water surface profile for the proposed roadway crossing. Next, we are going to display the results for the existing condition scenario in order to compare the results. To do this, right-click on the profile plot window and from the displayed context menu, select Plans. This will display a plan selection dialog box. Select the existing geometry plan and then click OK. Now we can see both plans in the profile plot. To better identify which plan each profile line corresponds to, click on the profile item listed in the plot legend. When we do that, the selected profile is highlighted on the profile plot. Taking a look at this profile plot comparison, we can see that the proposed roadway crossing bridge opening is not sized sufficiently large enough to handle the 100-year flow. We'll have to go back and reiterate the bridge opening design to handle this flow. We can see from this tutorial how to use Scenario Manager to manage multiple plans, or what GeoHECRAS refers to as scenarios, for doing HECRAS comparison analysis.